Look at this thing. It's transparent. Actually, it's not very transparent. You can see it's absorbing a lot of light, right? So if I cover this with a solar cell, it's going to be a mirror. That's not a good window. But if I can have a point contact here where I draw out the electrons and I absorb everywhere around it, it basically is an antenna in many respects. So it's a way of making transparent solar cells that are very efficient over long distances. We made a structure in an organic solar cell that we thought was an ordinary structure, but it wasn't. And then we were paying attention. What we found is that if you originate a charge a long distance from the detection point in an organic, it can still be detected with high efficiency. The electrons just keep going over very long distances. This was amazing because usually if you have your optics and you just go right off the contact, everything's done. It dies.
Looking at an electron going over a centimeter is almost impossible in silicon. It's almost impossible in any semiconductor. You have to really work to get the energetics right. Organics are usually thought of as like this kid brother. They have this perception, and rightly so, that they're poor conductors of electricity. Showing that this is possible in a semiconducting system that people think of as poor will hopefully open up new ideas.
The usual way one makes semiconductor devices like solar cells is batches, one wafer at a time. With organics, because you can put them on plastic substrate, you can do reel-to-reel, very much like we print newspapers. Organic materials are naturally disordered, so that when electrons travel, they always get stopped at these defects, they recombine, and they disappear. I've worked in the field of organic electronics for now 35 or so years. I know the myths better than anybody. Why would electrons go so far? It actually took us 2 years to unravel the mystery. The simplest fullerene is carbon-60. It is just 60 carbon atoms. And C70, which is the molecules that we used. So it's a tiny sphere. It's molecule-sized sphere. So it is not too much of a problem for an electron to hop from one sphere to the next sphere. It can always find a path. So this is what makes them really good electron conductors. Even though they form nice packed rafts, there's still lots of defects. Fortunately for us, it didn't stop the electrons. They found ways around the defects. Organic solar cells will be a major technology, a major solar solution in 10 years. The interesting thing about organics is there are many, many myths about them. And we've been knocking them down one at a time, and that's pretty exciting.